What is light? Something that makes vision possible. And that ripple you're seeing, it's a clue. But before we talk about light, we need to understand something deeper. What is a wave? A wave is a disturbance, a vibration that travels through space or matter, carrying energy. In the 17th century, many believed light was made out of tiny particles. Newton called them corpuscles. However, not everyone agreed. Dutch physicist Christian Huygens proposed a different idea, that light was actually a wave spreading out like ripples on a pond. Two brilliant minds, two completely opposite ideas, and for over a century, no one knew who was right. Then, in 1801, a simple experiment changed everything. Thomas Young shined a light through two narrow slits, and what he saw shocked everyone. Instead of two bright lines, he saw a pattern of light and dark bands. Interference, something only waves could do. However, waves required a medium, a disturbance to travel through. In this Roblox simulation, for instance, this plane serves as the medium for the waves. But when you look into the sky, you can see light coming from the sun traveling through the vacuum of space. No air, no water, no medium. So how can a wave travel through nothing? Physicists tried solving this issue by proposing something called the luminiferous ether, an invisible substance that filled all of space. But in 1887, the Michelson-Morley experiment tried to detect this ether by measuring how the speed of light changed as Earth moved into space. If the ether existed, light should travel faster or slower depending on our direction. But the result? No difference. Light always moved at the same speed no matter what. So this implied the ether didn't exist. However, two decades before the Michelson-Morley experiment were the equations of James Clerk Maxwell. In the 1860s, Maxwell brought together everything we knew about electricity and magnetism and discovered something that didn't just explain light, but revealed what it actually is. But how can electricity and magnetism, two seemingly separate forces, be connected to light? To answer that, we need to slow down. Let's take a step back and look at what electric and magnetic fields really are. Let's say we have a charged particle with an electric field. An electric field is just a vector field where we assign each point in space a corresponding vector. The force for each vector is described by Coulomb's law. A magnetic field looks like this and has a divergence of zero, which basically just means the amount of stuff or field lines flowing into any region equals the amount of stuff flowing out. This is for every line in the field, therefore it should always form a closed loop. So let's imagine this. We have a charged particle and we start to wiggle it back and forth. This motion causes the electric field to produce an oscillation. But in this simulation, each vector updates instantly, so visually nothing seems to happen. But in reality, fields don't transmit instantly. They propagate through space at a finite speed, like ripples on a pond. So let's imagine a slight delay, as if each part of the field takes some time to respond, and this creates something interesting. If the electric field oscillates in space and time, it can form local loops, and this rotation is described by the curl. So what is the curl? The curl tells us how much the field is circulating around an infinitesimal loop at a point, and in what direction. The curl vector points along the axis of rotation, and its magnitude tells us how strong the local rotation is. And curl itself is a vector field because it assigns a vector to each point in space. So here's the amazing part. The local rotation, or the curl, plays a key role in how electric and magnetic fields interact. But I'll be honest, I haven't fully learned the math behind Maxwell's equations yet, but I do know this. When the electric field changes over time, it creates a curling magnetic field. And when the magnetic field changes over time, it creates a curling electric field. This feedback loop is what lets the fields support each other and move forward through space. And that's what a light wave is, a self-sustaining pattern of electric and magnetic fields. I do have some animations on screen, though they are simplified. For instance, the most common image of an EM wave is just two waves perpendicular to each other while being in phase, which doesn't really give the full picture if you're thinking of vector fields. I'll leave some links in the description with more visuals and sources from people who can explain the full math better than I can right now. So when Maxwell worked out the equations for how electric and magnetic fields interact, he realized they naturally predict a wave moving at a fixed speed. That speed turned out to be about 300,000 kilometers per second, exactly the speed of light. So light must be an electromagnetic wave, right? But is that it? While light behaves perfectly as a wave in many situations, the story isn't quite finished. As we delve further into its nature, especially at a quantum level, we find that light sometimes acts like a particle.